take a look at the Bentley EXP 100 GT. No, seriously, take a look at it because it looks like nothing else on the road. It's not on the road, at least not yet, because this car is meant to preview what Bentley design and Bentley's future will look like in the year 2035. Boy, what a future we have to look forward to. And to help share a bit more about the car, we're going to invite Bentley Director of Design, Stefan Seeloff. Stefan, welcome.
Clint,
thank you for joining us. I appreciate it.
Good to see you.
So this is your baby for the future, and it's meant to preview a very exciting future for Bentley in particular.
Indeed.
And the car is packed with fun details. Electric, autonomous, high horsepower, crazy design. Start from the top. Just your favorite small details with the car.
Right. You know, we are incorporating a lot of technology roadmap innovations for 2035 in the EXP 100 GT to celebrate our centenary, but also to show the future of Bentley. And as Bentley has the famous matrix grille in the front for the last 100 years, we also obviously integrated a matrix grille into the front of the EXP 100 GT. But as the car is full electric, we don't need the cooling in the center of the car, but only on the side. Therefore, we integrated these 4,000 LEDs in the grille and also in the headlights to communicate with the car driver, bicycle rider, pedestrian, so with the whole environment, especially when the car is driven autonomously. And this is a little bit of a philosophical exercise. We did the whole thing with these 4,000 LEDs and 4,000 singular PCBs to create this also this movement in the front. And we did it together with a German light artist, Moritz Waldemeyer. So it was really only this part was a cooperation for 1 year. Yeah, obviously very, very special way of opening the doors to get people into the car, because we have the possibility to have two, three or four people in the car with the seat movements we are able to do. So you need a quite big opening. And you know, a lot of people told me, why is this door so big? I mean, I have problems maybe in the garage. The thing is, the EXP 100 GT is always possible to have autonomous mode. So let's say you arrive with your partner in front of the opera house, you get out of the car, doors are opening, you get out, you go into the opera house, the doors are closing and the car is just driving away on its own. And when you are coming, like you would have a chauffeur, right, when you are coming back from the opera, back the car comes and picks you up and delivers you at home.
Can you tell us about the design elements in the wheels specifically? There's colors that contrast all over the exterior of the vehicle, especially in the wheels.
In the wheel especially, there's another story contained. The wheel is actually changing in different driving modes. So the faster you drive, the wheels are opening slightly and you get more air into the brakes. So the brake calipers, which are behind these wheel covers, are, let's say, getting more breathing air to be cooled. We still have our so-called horseshoe element we have in all our Bentleys. And in this special detail is a bit more story behind it. We assume that this is all a three-dimensional OLED display. So all you see over here is in the future OLED display. And you have then this illumination, this movement also from the rear lights into the display. You can do some writing.
So the display is, when the lights are off, the display is seamless in the bodywork.
Exactly. You can't even and it's there. Three-dimensional, you know. A technology which is not yet available. You get these curved screens today already, but to make them three-dimensional is not possible yet. So this is another, let's say, futuristic assumption.
And these lighting elements right here along the roof. Now, does this have to do with the interior of the vehicle or is this a design element?
Yeah, we are talking about light harvesting. So we are harvesting the light and it's almost like a chandelier that is then in the night, if you want, delivering a very warm feeling, a cocoon feeling in the rear of the passenger compartment.
So now we're inside of the vehicle and you are certainly not where a normal front passenger would be sitting. Talk about the interior layout. You said it's workable as well, where you can have a couple different configurations with passengers.
So I'm in the moment in the reclining seat, and the same seat you see over here could also be on the other side. So the driver's seat can go to the back. The rear seat is disappearing in the rear, like you can see over here. So you normally have four seats, but we can start with two seats. So it's also possible then, obviously, that the driver's seat moves forward, the steering wheel arrives, the pedal arrives, and then the active driving mode is possible. And then behind, you have another seat. The same thing can happen with this seat, moving forward, behind, another seat appears. So you can also have a driving configuration with four passengers. You don't see any controls, you don't see any switches.
No displays, no screen, no display. Anything.
The display is integrated in the front screen. It's okay. A transparent OLED display, so all the visual information, as far as you need them, are given through the OLED display in the front screen. And then you have an artificial intelligence unit in the front and in the rear, where you can literally operate and interact with the car. Also, on top, you are literally talking to the car. So these are, let's say, the three possibilities to interact with the EXP100 GT. Very organic materials and also sustainable materials. So, for example, the artificial intelligence units, we have been doing together. They are made out of glass, and we made them with Cumbria Crystal, the last glass producer in Britain. And we are incorporating over here not only technology but also a craftsmanship ability. So this mixture of high-end technology and craftsmanship ability. All the other materials you see over here are not the classic leather hides you find today in a Bentley. We experimented a lot with fabrics, so what you see in the door panels.
And what is covering the seats? Is that leather specifically, or is that an alternative material?
This is leather in the front of the seat. It still is a special soft leather, but we have also certain leather parts in the seat that are so-called vinea material. So it's a leftover from the wine producing industry. So it's an organic material, but it is animal free, let's say. So the stitching is illuminated, and it's not only stitching, it's a so-called trapunto technique. We've been working together with a traditional company in London, existing for 500 years, producing the crowning robes for the British kings and queens. And it is literally a three-dimensional textile. We have been using, it's a silk textile. So the river wood is a material you find in rivers. It's wood that sits sometimes 4,000 to 5,000 years in the rivers. We dig it out and we infused it with a special copper material. So this explains also this special, let's say, kind of bloom of the wood. And we only polish it afterwards, and we use it everywhere in the dashboard unit, in the seats, and also in the center console. It is obviously very decorative, but on the other side also very sustainable. When you want to have a drink, you have a special water delivery over here.
It pulls the water from where?
It is, as we have no motor in front, we have a lot of space under the front canopy, and we have like of cartridges you can load into the car, or a service company can load them into the car. And then it's, for example, warm, hot towels can be delivered through the center console, because the center console is movable and there is a unit in there that moves out. But also a water displayer that delivers directly the fresh water into the carafe. So you can have, while you are in the car, having a glass of water.
So there's an area under the hood that basically is there for room service items, so to speak.
Exactly. So to speak,
along,
so to speak, so to speak,
exactly. Into the main cabin.
Exactly, exactly. Maybe the very last thing we got in this unit is a part that is, I would say, with our knowledge of today, it's almost like a USB stick. So it contains memories while you are traveling and having a grand tour with the EXP100 GT. It contains and collects memories, whatever you want. And this is this unit over here, and you can take this later with you as a kind of digital device, and you can feed it at home into your home system. You can watch certain aspects, landscapes, whatsoever you wanted to collect during your grand tour. So you don't have to worry and do photos. Everything is, let's say, digitally collected in these little units, and there are some more in the front.
Thank you for the time.
Thank you so much.
On the car.